We're really fortunate to have with us Sharmila Tagore. God bless you and all the work you do. It's amazing that you're so committed, and people, you have such a huge fan following, so what you say people listen to. So I just wanted to ask you, with so much respect that we all have for our senior citizens, they're still last in the line. Why is that?
Well, Pranoy, I'm so glad in a way that we have started this conversation about elders. You know, when you're talking about last in the line during the pandemic, but it has been a reality for the last quite a few years, you know. They have been the last. And as a society, as India, we have always put elders on center stage. But something over the years have changed, maybe because of the nuclear families, I don't quite know. But now the stress and the attention is more on the youth. And one possible reason is, or maybe the possible reason is, that the seniors are not perceived as a productive energy, productive force. So therefore, I think is the low priority. You know, and let me share a statistics with you. The numbers of seniors in India, I believe, is 11 million today. And it can triple, it will triple, it is expected to triple in the next 30 years or so. And we are still not paying adequate attention to this. So as I said, that you have started this conversation, and I sincerely hope, fervently hope, that we will sustain it.
You know, one of the big issues, and it's a very correct thing, of course, that we must have social distancing, that we must keep away from people who are could be without any symptoms, could be infected and could be infectious. So with social distancing, again, our seniors and our elders are going to suffer the most. So how do we, you know, get around that problem? How do you do it, for example?
You know, of course, we must remain engaged and connected. And that is absolute necessity at this time, because all of us are locked in, and it's a very unprecedented time. I, for one, is not allowed by my doctor to step out. So, I mean, thanks to Zoom and thanks to FaceTime and thanks to all these gizmos, you know, the geography has shrunk and we are able to communicate, you know. So I think it is. And then, of course, we have to ring up each other. We have to look for a community. We have to engage with our neighbors. In whichever way, we must remain engaged. I've got a little deck outside and I can see a lot of sky. It not necessarily be human beings, but I see a beautiful sunset. I see lots of birds, you know, orchestra of birds, beautiful flowers, because spring is here or was here. It's almost departing, but beautiful flowers. So, you know, you must engage. Otherwise, it's going to be very difficult. And, you know, I have an 82-year-old friend, relative in London, apartment, all alone. She's doing everything herself. And she so delightfully empowered, you know. I get so much inspiration from her. So there are many ways of staying engaged. And of course, there are books, there's music.
Ji.
Depending on, you know, where we are, I don't want to sound elitist. Ji. But all of us have a community. And now we maybe have a digital community, but we have to interact and build on that community. All of us are looking for a structure. All of us are looking for some kind of positivity. And through that community, we will get it.
एक आपकी फिल्म थी अमर प्रेम, और आज जो हमारा बुजुर्गों को हम जिस तरह से याद करें, उनकी मदद कैसे करें, उसका जो आखिरी में था, जब आप उम्र दराज उसमें हो जाती हैं, तो एक लड़के को आपने पाला पोसा था. विनोद मेहरा बड़े होकर आते हैं और आपको अपने घर ले जाते हैं. तो शायद वो सीन मेरे जहन में बहुत याद आ रहा था, और जब पता लगा आप आएंगी, यही वही मैसेज हम एनडीटीवी और हेल्पेज इंडिया देना चाह रहे हैं कि हमें अपने बुजुर्गों को उस उम्र के पड़ाव में उनका ध्यान रखना है। क्या कुछ उसकी याद है?
उसमें और भी इम्पोर्टेंट मैसेज है, जो हमारे बायोलॉजिकल फैमिली है उससे ज्यादा हमारा जो फैमिली को हम चूज करते हैं, ये जो लड़का उसका आखिर में देखभाल करता है वो उसका लड़का नहीं है, जो आदमी उसके पास उसको सहारा देता है उसका हस्बैंड नहीं है, मगर फिर भी दिस कम्युनिटी, दिस नॉन बायोलॉजिकल फैमिली इज वॉट रियली सपोर्ट्स हर। सो दैट्स द लेसन, वी नीड नॉट ओनली लुक एट आवर फैमिली, वी हैव टू लुक एट द एक्सटेंडेड फैमिली दैट वी कैन क्रिएट इन आवर लाइफ टाइम थ्रू आवर ऑप्शंस, थ्रू आवर चॉइसेस।
Can I just ask you a personal question?
Yes.
What kind of some memories you have of your grandparents, and just if you could recount anything about them?
You know, my grandmother couldn't speak a word of English, and my grandfather always ate with knife and fork and was, you know, played the piano. He wrote our absent letters, and he was very different. And my grandmother was, of course, wouldn't eat lots of food that my grandfather enjoyed, but she didn't eat it herself, but she would cook. And when he passed away, we encouraged her. She used to be wonderful with her cooking. She was wonderful with her crochet. So we decided that we are going to get her some money, you know. So we told all our friends that she's going to crochet little things like napkins, tray cloths, doily, you know, glass covers, etc. And we would give her some material like chindis from various cloth. And she did it, and it became such a success. At the end of the month, she would get about, those days, about 2,500 rupees or 5,000 rupees. And that made her so happy. So in a way, that was empowering for her. Otherwise, she was always, you know, looked after us and looked after her bahus. And I come from a joint family, so there was no social distancing as such. But there was so much to learn, and there was so much support and love. And of course, thappars also. There was lots of discipline and lots of, strictures also on us. We couldn't do what we wanted.
So you have lovely memories, but is it tough being a grandmother these days?
No, not at all. Not at all, because I don't interfere, you know. It's so important to have a life of your own.
No
thappar? Oh my God. I think they will report me to some higher authority or something. No, those things have changed. It is now a negotiation and dialogues, and it's no longer
lovely.
I told you so, and therefore you do it. So that time is gone, because there is so much, there's social media.
Thank you so much for being with us and recounting all these lovely memories. We treasure them. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.